Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let's take a look at what's new on your iPhone in iOS 26.1. Now, earlier this week, Apple released iOS 26.1 for your iPhone. If your iPhone was compatible with iOS 26, you could upgrade now to 26.1. To do that, just go to the Settings app and then to General, and then look for Software Update. It will then search for the software update and walk you through updating your iPhone. Perhaps the most talked about new feature is the ability to tone down the new liquid glass look a bit. If you go into Settings and then you scroll down to find Display and Brightness, you'll see this new liquid glass setting. Select that and you can choose between clear, which is exactly how iOS 26 looked, and a tinted look here, which will make many of the controls more opaque, like this. Don't expect too big of a change, though. For instance, with clear on, this is what Control Center looks like. And you're not really going to notice any difference if you turn on tinted. The difference is more pronounced when you're looking at controls. Like, look at the controls here at the bottom of Safari. This is with the setting set to clear, and this is with the setting set to tinted. Take a look at Maps while it's set to clear. And now look at how it looks when set to tinted. Now, if you really want it to part from the clear look in liquid glass, you still have the setting in accessibility under display and text size, and you could turn on reduce transparency. Now you'll notice that the control center blanks out everything behind it and other things like the dock down here at the bottom that were transparent before are now much more opaque. But do note that if you have reduced transparency turned on, then if you go back to display and brightness, you can no longer switch between clear and tinted. Reduced transparency overrides either one. Now, a big change that you will notice if you use alarms on your iPhone, I'm going to create one here that will go off in 1 minute. And then I'm going to lock my phone, and you'll see how things have changed now when the alarm goes off. So you can see here, when the alarm goes off, I've got a large snooze button, but if I want to stop the alarm, I can't just tap on this. I have to slide it over to the right to stop it. This prevents you from accidentally hitting the stop button instead of the snooze button. Now, another new feature that involves sliding is in the Music app. So now, when you're playing music in the Music app, you've got the little mini player here at the bottom. Before, you would have buttons that you would tap to go to the next song or the previous song in the playlist or album. But now you can swipe. So to go to the next song, I just swipe from right to left. And there's a third feature that involves swiping. If you're on your lock screen, you probably know that you can swipe from the right to the left to go right to the camera. Now, you may know because you use that a lot, or you may know because you accidentally do it all the time and it's annoying. iOS 26.1 allows you now to turn that off. So you would go to Settings and then go and look, of course, for Camera. And then there's a new setting down here for Lock Screen Swipe to Open Camera, and you can turn that off. Now, while we're in Settings, let's go back here and go to Privacy and Security. There's a new setting that's all the way at the bottom under Background Security Improvements. And you can now turn on automatically install. It should be on by default. And this will install important security updates quietly in the background. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MacMost at Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. And now I've got one more setting for you. If you go to the top level and then go to General here, there's a new setting under Local Capture. Local Capture is the new feature in iOS 26 that allows you to record when you're on a phone call or FaceTime. Now you can choose the save location for where those recordings go, and you can choose audio only if you want to record, say, FaceTime, but just the audio portion. So this feature is handy if you use FaceTime to record a podcast. You can get the audio recording saved without doing anything special. Once you've got FaceTime going, you can bring up Control Center. And then if you don't have it already, you can add the control for Local Capture. And then you could turn that on to capture the audio or audio and video from the FaceTime call. Now, for some people, all these changes are nothing compared to the big change of the addition of new languages for Apple Intelligence and for live translation. These are the new languages added for Apple Intelligence. So if you're using one of these languages, you just got all of the Apple Intelligence features that weren't available to you before. And also for live translations, these are the new languages that are available in iOS 26.1. And of course, this update also features lots of bug fixes and small updates. Like for instance, the Apple TV icon here looks a little bit different. When you go into settings, you may notice that some of the headings for some of the settings now are left justified and little things like that. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.